today is a new day. We're gonna make today work. We're gonna make this day a great day. How you doing?
I'm actually off work now, I know.
But it ain't late for devotion, you know what I mean?
So today's devotion is from Isaiah 55 verses 8. It says that, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways your ways, declares the Lord." So this can be broad. I can talk about a lot of stuff with this, but what I actually really want to talk about is how God answered my prayer in a different way than I thought. I remember one time I was driving on an empty tank because it was a while back, and I was living paycheck to paycheck. I was paying student loans, paying car insurance, paying rent, paying phone bill, this and that, all sorts of things that, you know, were taking my money away, and they cut hours at work and whatnot, and I literally was living paycheck to paycheck, week by week, and not knowing where my next gas is gonna come from, you know? So, there are two incidents, and actually the same week that God answered, well, not same week, but like same month, I believe. So I remember one week I was completely out of gas, and we had a church convention thing, but it was in a different city, not city, but like a different, like, okay, I'm in the north and it's supposed to be in the south, and it's like a 50-minute drive or whatever, and I literally had almost a quarter to an empty gas. I had to go pick up my pastor's wife, I had to go pick her up from her house and then go to church from there. And I had a change in like a $5 or whatever. So I was like, oh God, I don't know how I'm gonna do this, but I really wanna go to this church thing. And I don't like to ask people for money. Like, even my mom, I hardly ask her for anything, especially money. And so I just figured, you know, the little bit of change that I had, I was gonna use it to give me some gas and then get home and then wait till Friday when I get paid. So that was the deal. We're just gonna trust God and just go. So I did. I went to go pick up my pastor's wife, and then when I got there, she was like, let's get some gas. And I was like, what? Really? Okay. And I thought that was strange because, like, I was literally almost empty by the time I got to her house, because her house is a bit far from my house. So by the time I got there, I was running on an empty tank, you know, and I had to buy a $5 gas to make it to the church thing and then make it back home. And then wait till Friday or whatever. And I was like, wow, God is amazing. And then there was another day. I think it was the same month, I believe. Because that month was really hard. Like I said, they cut hours at work. I was driving another day on an empty tank. I went to go visit my friend. She just had a baby, and I went to go sleep over at her house to kind of help her out and whatnot. And like I said, I don't ask people for anything. I don't know, but you should ask, you know, if you're in need of something and you're in need of help. Yeah, sometimes it's kind of hard to ask people, especially when you hit rock bottom and you're just like, I don't want anybody to know my situation or know what's going on. But sometimes people are just willing to help, and I'm so blessed that I'm willing to help anybody that asks, or, you know, just whatever, just help however I can. Anyway, I'm going off track, but not really, but kind of. Let me finish my story. I left my friend's house, and I was on my way to work. I had a meeting that started, it's supposed to start at 7, but I was presenting that morning, so I was supposed to be there before 7, and so I decided to leave the house like around 6:15-ish so I could make it on time. Well, I didn't even make it out of the house. I was trying to get to the gas station and buy some gas and then head over, because like it was a Thursday night, and so we don't get paid until Friday. So I got paid on Friday, and so Friday morning is when I could get gas. So I was gonna go get gas, and I just needed to like turn into the gas station, and right before I got like right on the freeway, because there was no gas station before that. So on the freeway, my car gets stuck. So I'm just there, I'm like, oh my God, what do I do? What do I do? And guess what? This guy pulls up next to me, and then he goes, do you need some help? And I'm like, yes, I need help. My car wouldn't start. So he had like a whole gallon full of gas and he just put it all in my car. And immediately I ran to the nearest gas station and I bought a full tank. Cause I got paid. I got paid that Friday morning. So basically, the whole point I'm trying to make here is that you gotta trust God. When you do trust God and you pray to God for something, don't have an expectation, but don't have your own way of, don't limit God, basically. Don't limit God. Say like, okay, this is how it's supposed to come, or I'm praying to God for this, and then you envision how you're gonna get it or how it's gonna come. No. Like the Bible says, for his thoughts are not our thoughts, his ways are not our ways. You know, the way he's gonna answer prayer is not the way that we think. Sometimes it's totally different. I was thinking that, you know, just start the car for me so I can just cross the street and go get some gas. Meanwhile, he's like, nope, I'm sending you someone to get you some gas, and then you can drive and go get gas. And I'm like, wow. And you know, sometimes it's like, we say, God, help me, teach me patience, and teach me this, and help me to become this. And guess what? The only way you're gonna get there is through tests and trials. He's gonna test you, give you a situation where you're supposed to exercise patience. And that's how it's gonna be, because they will come. And sometimes one thing that I do is that whenever I pray to God for something, I record it down, as in I write it down. That way when the prayer is answered, I just check it off. And this is one thing that I learned from my pastor's wife. She lists everything that she asked God for, because that sometimes like the answer will come and you wouldn't even realize it. So yeah, that's my little bit for you today. Don't limit God. Be expectant, but do not expect an answer in a certain way that you're thinking is best, because he knows what's best. We're about to go home. Today is church day. Yay. Today's Wednesday and church day. So we gonna be going to church. We gonna go praise the Lord. Yes, hallelujah. Yeah, we should schedule another date night with Jesus, you know? Try to have a date night every week, or as often as possible. What about you? Let me know. Let me know your thoughts. Has God answered your prayers in a different way than you thought? Or is it just me? You know, just let me know. Comment below. And also that would inspire me to make more videos of such, if you like it. So yeah, that's it. I'm home again, waiting to be let in. Yeah. I am home. Yes, so yes, I'm home. No, you're not.
Yes.
About to make me some mad contains, yo. So no, just kidding. Let me see. Oh, I'm about to make me some contains. It's same day. Looking all fresh. I'm going to church. So like I said, we're gonna get our praise on. I'm actually a little late because I wasn't sure what time it started. I thought it started at 7:30, but 7, so. That's mad crazy, y'all. Mad crazy. I almost got a dimple. Like, why did God give me a dimple? Like, you can only see it when I do this. But I can't be doing that forever. End it here. Always remember to be yourself, do what you love yourself, trust in God, and put him first.